Oof. Okay, so this is for Monday, the 26th of July, 2021. My name is Collins, and I've come to bother you about dueling realities. Just for simplification, let's say that humanity is split between those who believe A and those who believe B. The people who claim A and the people who claim B. Just for simplification. A is one set of ideas about what is true, and B is another set, and each camp believes the other is at best deluded, or at worst criminal. So they are competing realities. One may be closer to the truth, as in, you know, objectively measurable truth, but that doesn't seem to matter as much anymore in this context. Group A tries to convince Group B that they've made a mistake. They feel that through the patient use of reason and logic, they can bring the other group to their senses. Group B doesn't have any use for reason and logic. They don't trust those things. They are the people who believe in B because they are those people. That's who they are, and those are their people, and they're not going to be disloyal. Now complicate that situation by making reality itself easier to synthesize and falsify so that even the most hard-headed, rational person can be made to doubt what reality really is. Is that false? Is that fake news? Or did it really happen? Who said that? Did they really say that? When did they say that? So now it would appear that each competing reality can produce evidence of its rightness, compelling enough at least for its adherence. Now, complicate the situation further by having an external mafiocracy intervene and disrupt people's formation of reality. This outside power has an interest in keeping everybody befuddled and confused. They want to disrupt your ability to test for true and false. They like to have you confused. So now, even though one of them may be false, the dueling realities become functionally equivalent. The one side cannot argue the other side away. Each claim has the power of conviction. So that's like a recipe for a pretty fucked up situation, I guess. At the moment, Group A and Group B still belong to the same species. They can interbreed. But I start to wonder if their divergent realities will continue to drive them apart so that after, you know, tens of thousands of years, maybe they'll be completely distinct creatures living on the same planet somehow. Or will they? I don't know. I wish I could say history shows us that this will happen and then it'll be okay again in the future. I don't know that. The deep fissures in society tend to last much longer than they are useful or even relevant. Think of all the historical grudges held by one people against another for real or imagined wrongs of centuries ago. What's different now is that mind is different. Consciousness is more turbulent today. Because of all the extra inputs and because some people just like to poke at it and see it jump. I guess the only advice I can offer is let us hold on to faith that there is such a thing as reality and keep looking for it. Well, that's all I have to say about that. If you have something to say about that, put it there, please. If I'm really lucky, I'll be back again to see you next week and bother you some more. But in the meantime, I hope that you and all your distinct creatures will have a feine Abend, Ferder.